still on the camera.
All right, it's a good thing you didn't say. First, I like we should give these guys a round of applause for getting up here. So. All right, what these guys do isn't too easy. It's kind of nerve-wracking speaking in front of a crowd. Matt and I know this because we've experienced it ourselves. So just be patient with them. So, Deneen.
Hi, for all of you that don't know me, my name's Nick Deneen. I've been here for 2 years. I've played on the hockey and lacrosse team. From both of those teams, I've taken away a sense of brotherhood that I would like, that I've not yet experienced throughout this whole community. But as prefect, I would like to facilitate this through shared experiences, just as we have shared as a hockey team and the lacrosse team. Brotherhood is really important to me because it's the foundation of South Kent. It's what we base our whole community around, but I'm sad to say that I haven't experienced it throughout the whole community. Like, it's just been with my hockey team, it's just been with my lacrosse team, but I would like to experience it with all of you guys. Looking left and right and knowing your brother has your back is something that, like, it's a really important thing to me, because it's something, it's a feeling that I know that some of you haven't had yet, but I'd like for you guys to share that experience with me. I know many of you have known that I've made mistakes in the past, but however, I think this could help me make a better prefect out of myself and a better person, and it can help. I can help the boys who need help, and going through these experiences, I can maybe get a better understanding of what my buddies are going through, or whoever I may be talking to, and then I can help create a bridge between the faculty and the students, and give the faculty a better understanding of what the students are doing and what they're feeling as well. I think that I am a pretty good leader. I think of myself as a silent leader. I lead by example, but doing these things is very important because there needs to be someone to follow, even though if I'm not saying, let's do this, let's do that, and if I'm doing the right thing and I'm just leading by example, then I know that others will follow in my footsteps as well. And just want to make this a great year for you boys. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Zheng Haodong from Qingdao, China, and today I'm running for prefect. South Kent has changed me as a person. I really like to challenge myself to become a better student, better athlete, and a better leader. And that's why I'm here today. To start with my own personal story about challenge. I learned hockey in a year with no foundations, and all I do is put on a pair of skates and start practice. With all of the support from my friends and my own practice time, I become a current hockey player in a year. I tried to become an active member in the community, and I already had a bond with different groups of people in the community. And here's my leadership experience. I am a dorm junior in Gilder, captain of cross-country team and crew team, and also I am a student council for both my sophomore year and junior year. I will continue using my experience to make this place a better place. As an international student and living in various countries, I understand what it means to embrace people as my own. I don't see color, religion, or culture. I see a person, and that person is my South African brothers. And I won't treat you different because what sport you play or what country you come from, but I will use all of my power to be fair and equal. I still remember my first year at South Ken. I spoke very little English, and it was very hard for me to start a conversation with anybody. Though, that did not prevent me from stretching beyond my comfort zone and talk to different people. During that time, no one was in my corner to help me to assimilate into South Ken community, but I will utilize my experience and my leadership quality to make sure that all the students are embraced and appreciated by this community. I don't make any promises that I can't keep, but today I promise to you that I will do my best and everything in my power to make next year a great school year. The three things that we always talk about in South Ken inspires me a lot in the past 3 years. Self-reliance, simplicity of life, and directness of purpose. I will continue these three things next year, so that way we can make this a better place and approach the true value of South Ken community. Thank you.
Hi, so for all that you don't know me, I'm Hunter Coaches from Shelton, Connecticut. I've been on the prep soccer team for 2 years. I'm a 2 year boy. Being on the prep soccer team, you meet a lot of people from different cultures, and you create a family, kind of. Those guys are the closest guys to me, and it's kind of sad seeing like how you have the hockey team here and all that. So it'd be kind of nice if we could get together, and I'm not saying break up the groups, but if we could get the groups to come together rather than trying to split them up, you know, getting the soccer team, go to the hockey games like we did, getting the hockey team coming out for when we play Berkshire, all that. It's really nice to feel. And I feel like if we do that, we could create a stronger community than we already have. And through this, it'll also create a more comfortable feel for the international kids that are not involved in the athletics. And, you know, you could go support them when they could go do their robotics and everything. This community is based around support, and I feel like if we get that together, it could be really comfortable for everyone. Through these 2 years, I've had challenges that I can relate to everyone with, whether it's in the dorm, athletic, academically. I really just want to be the guy that people could come to, follow me as I'm a silent leader. And I want to also be the connector between the faculty and the students. I know through these past 2 years, I've learned how the school works. I know how it works pretty well, actually. And for the new students, I want to be the one that they could come to, ask any questions in the beginning of the year, and just help them out. And it'd just be really nice if we could get that together. And not only that, it's just, Dong said, the simplicity of life. You just don't want to worry about that stuff. You just want to go through your life, go to school, get your work done, and just have fun while doing it. And I feel like if we do all this stuff, we can make that happen. Thank you.
Changes being made by Florida. spreading the South Kenya spirit. 3 years ago today, one by one, I walked down to the stage to give their lectures. I had my and at the same time began for good evening, everyone. It is an honor for me to speak here, and it feels wonderful to be back with my community in such a special way. Having started my hero's journey as a freshman, in these 3 years, I have witnessed a numerous amount of changes being made by former prefects and faculty on spreading the South Kenya spirit. 3 years ago today, seeing juniors, one by one, walked onto the stage to make their lectures. I admired them, and at the same time began feeling nervous because I knew that someday I might also be one of them taking part in the same glorious process to speak in front of all these wise eyes. 3 years ago today, I was innocent but ambitious. As the writer Tracy K. Smith mentioned, just like the life in which I'm forever a child, looking out my window at the night sky, thinking one day I will touch the world by bare hands, even if it burns. 3 years swiftly passed by, and tonight we all assemble under the glorious light and play our own roles in another great annual election. I am convinced that every leader has their distinctive leadership style. Today, I will share with you a portion of what I have learned in these 3 years and how the knowledge I gained relates to the South Kenya community. Before coming to South Kenya, I was in my hometown, Shanghai, China, an urban society being dominated by modern technology. Under the atmosphere fulfilled by fast living pace, heavy traffic, and limited natural setting, I began witnessing that numerous people experience a lot of pressure and negativity. Since that time, I have become convinced that technology is not the savior of the modern generation, because those colorful screens could sometimes generate invisible pressure and block us from seeing the real beauty around us, which is the nature. In my hometown, I was tired of this kind of lifestyle, tired of being constrained in a society with only man-made structures, and tired of missing my beloved friend, nature. Therefore, I came to US, came to South Kent School, a school on the hillside. In South Kent, I see the stars that I have never seen in my city due to the light pollution. I see the eastern white pine in the forest trying to get me high five when I was running. And I see the bright moon in the clear sky, reminding and vividly explaining a poem I learned in middle school, which I never got a chance to fully comprehend. How beautiful and amazing our mother nature is. She connects the past and the present, and like a prophet, indicates the future of my presence and here tonight. Yes, the nature is our healer who provides us comfort and relax our mind. I would love to share my encounter with nature to all of you. This winter, I went to Chiwangki, a semester school in Maine focusing on relationship between human and nature. In this amazing place, I learned the power of unity in student body, increased my appreciation toward nature, and challenged myself to being fully embraced by the nature. Staying alone in the woods for straight 48 hours with only a tarp and a dry bag, which has the resources I need to maintain my health. In those 48 hours, I woke up by the sounds of the birds I ate my meals in front of the ocean waves, and I fell asleep under the crystal pure moonlight. I would love to share this great experience with everyone sitting in this room. I am passionate to start an environmental therapy program, also as known as the forest bathing, to give everyone the opportunity to experience the healing power of nature. The opportunity could either be laying down on the lawn, on the grass, on a sunny day, or taking a walk with the friends into the woods, or just close your eyes and listen for the birds for several minutes. Everyone with a different perception will gain their unique experience through this program. The idea of forest bathing could not only relax students' mind, but also could raise students' awareness of how to treat our environment. Under the umbrella of forest bathing, many activities could be started. For example, an activity students enjoyed in Chiwanki is called the walk jar, meaning taking a walk into the forest with your friends or a person you're completely unfamiliar with. Walk jar program will let one student take a walk with a partner. The person who is willing to take a walk with a random partner could write his name on paper and put into the walk jar. The jar will open once a month, and the participants will be randomly paired up, like two people a pair. The chosen pair has to take a walk into the woods or at the bike trail which Ms. Jennings recently renovated. This project will increase the intimacy between the students and dissipate the idea of the groups. These ideas tie back to one of Mr. Rennie's longtime concern about the existence of different small circles in the community. I would reason this concern as our unfamiliarity with each other and maybe our unwillingness to open ourselves to others in front of the public. Not many non-athletic students take the chance to have a private conversation with a student athlete, and vice versa. Now the students will be paired up into small groups, which encourage the students to have the opportunity to start the conversation and feel comfortable to talk with each other in a small setting. I know a lot of information has been covered, and I'm really excited for it. According to what I just mentioned, you might be able to see that my leadership style is nurture, caring about the students' mental health, stress level, and want to help students to elevate their minds to a higher level through the forest bathing. Also, I'm an analyst, a person who is able to provide planning and resources to others, such as the work jar idea. This is the reason that I think I could be a prefect who is capable to unite the community and make exciting and beneficial changes. Last but not least, I would like to read a quote from David Sobule. Let us accept the nature not only in sense, but in fortune gratitude of providence, which by such means detached us from an excessive love to earthly things and elevates our mind to celestial and divine. Thank you, everyone. Have a good night.
Hello, my name is Paul Messina. Hello. Hello, my name is Paul Messina, and I'm here today to prove to you that I will excel as a prefect at South Kent School. Even though I have only been here a year, I have come a long way from when I first arrived in September. When I first arrived, I wasn't the most mature kid in the fifth form. I was self-absorbed, arrogant, and argumentative. But now I stand here today, letting all of my teachers and brothers know just how much I have grown this year. I want to thank everyone in the community for caring about me growing as a person this year and helping me become the man I am today, which is much different from the boy I was when I first arrived at school. I have matured immensely due to the constant help of my peers and faculty surrounding me. The people at this campus have been role models to me, especially this year's prefects. They have inspired me to stand here today and give this speech to you because I too want to be a role model just as they have been one for me. If you want a prefect who will look out for your best interests and wholeheartedly help support you in any events during and after your time here at South Kent, and if you want a mature, dedicated role model as a prefect next year, then I hope you all will give me a chance and consider me. I just want to say one more thing. It's pretty emotional to me, but I feel as though I can say it because you are all my brothers here. It has always been a dream of mine to play hockey for Penn State, and people always told me that that dream was impossible. I also decided that I wanted to be a prefect. Likewise, people told me that it wasn't going to happen. But that doesn't mean I'm not going to try and invest my whole heart and all of my energy into it, because that's the type of person I am. If I see something is right or is needed, I'm going to fight like crazy for it. And I would hope that's what you want for a prefect, someone that's going to give all of their energy and fight no matter how slim the chances may be. Thank you for your time.
Hello, everybody. For those of you who do not know me, my name is Jack Rovellotti. I believe I would be the students' and faculty's best choice for head prefect. Unlike many schools, here at South Kent, we students have a lot of influence. Mr. Vadney and the rest of the faculty are always willing to listen to our ideas and are open to change. However,
what?
However, over my
Marty, bro.
However, over my years here, I've realized that students don't utilize this influence to the best of our advantage. Well, as head prefect, this is where I'm going to come in. I will help the student body use this influence in an appropriate way to benefit our academic, social, living, and athletic schedules and agendas. At the end of the day, it's the student's school, and I want the students, backed by the prefects, to be making the decisions. For example, I believe we students should have more on-campus activities. However, I don't think the faculty should always be choosing what these activities are, because they are not the ones participating in them. The activities chosen by the students would be a great way for everybody to come together, so we don't have just the hockey guys hanging out with the hockey guys, or the soccer guys hanging out with the soccer guys. While having fun, I feel like this will create a stronger bond for the students and ultimately lead to less controversy. It should not just stop here. In addition, the students will be able to pick off-campus trips on weekends and weekdays so we don't end up with half-full trips. If worked out correctly, I also believe I can make it so that the students can possibly pick meals in the dining hall or portions of it. Hey, maybe we can even get some air conditioning in the dorms. On the faculty side, I will help create a stronger bond between the students and teachers by listening to both sides. I know this will be tough, but I will value a teacher's opinion as much as a student. If a teacher needs me to make a tough decision, I will make that tough decision if I feel it will benefit the well-being of the school. Through ups and downs, everybody's opinion and side will be heard and genuinely listened to. Lastly, I want to end by telling you why I didn't knock at the knocking ceremony on Monday. I'm a modest leader and thought it would be better to be nominated by my brothers and teachers, because honestly, anybody can just stand up and go knock on a table. Thank you for listening to me.
Hey everyone, what's up? For those of you that don't know me, my name is Bobby Starring from Springfield, Virginia, and I'm a Gilder Dorm Junior right now who's running for prefect. To me, a good prefect is someone who can listen to and understand any concerns or ideas of the students and just tries to help as best they can in that situation. That could include anything, like communicating that idea with the faculty respectfully, or even just being someone you can seek out and talk to. I think I would be a great prefect for a couple of reasons. One of them being I'm still a one-year boy, and I would be able to take anything I went through this year and use it to help new students next year. I would just try to make anything they go through, especially the transition to a new school, easier. I'm also one of four boys in my family, which has made my house a miniature and simplified version of this place in a way. There are a lot of similarities between the two, including a brotherhood, a curfew with parents that come around and yell if lights are indeed not out, and anything that comes up, we have to deal with it. This is where I think I can do a great job as a prefect, because my whole life I've had to listen to anything that has come up and tried my best to help. Finally, I think I would make a good prefect because I play sports and joke around and go to class and just do everything that you do because I am one of you, which will make listening and trying to do the best I can that much easier. Thank you for taking your time to listen to me, and goodbye.
I don't really know how I'm going to follow that up, but for you guys who don't know, my name is Garrett Sundquist, and I'm here today to tell you that I want to be your prefect next year. But I don't want to just be a prefect for you guys. I want to be your head prefect. And I know you guys might say to yourself that that's a little bold, but I think I'm more than capable of the position. Being prefect for you guys has been something that I've been seriously thinking about for the past 2 years. I believe I am very qualified for this position as well. With both of my older brothers graduating from here, I've seen how the school has worked for years, and I believe that I have very good insight on what the students want, as well as the reachable goals that we can achieve as a community. Speaking on community, something that I love about this place is that even though I'm a Selects hockey player, as you guys know, I have a place wherever I go in this school. Whether it is in the rink, the court, or the classroom, I don't just belong to one single group, and I think that's something really special that we have here. As your prefect, I will communicate with the students, faculty, and staff to the best of my ability. I can't make any promises like a politician might, but I will let you guys know that I will do my best to make your year as productive and enjoyable for all of us here on the hillside. I think with the right group of guys next year that this school can make major strides in the right direction and continue to strive for greatness. I'm extremely excited for this opportunity. I hope that you guys consider me for your class of 2019, Prefect.
So, I'm Oliver Woody Asana, and I'm going to be going in a slightly different order than everybody else by starting off what would be my shortcomings as a leader. So, I think my greatest shortcoming, as any of you who've ever worked with me in a group project should know, is I am terrible at planning. Everything last minute, nothing done in advance, just like this speech right now. But I think that isn't a complete negative, because out of not having planning, there's also adaptability. And I think that is important for a prefect to have, as with the election being the previous year of the year that you're prefect, you don't know what's going to be coming next year. You don't know who's going to be there. You don't know what events are going to happen. And I think it is important for a prefect to be able to adapt to their situation and be able to make quick decisions and not have to rely on their plans. Other than that, if we jump back to when I first came here, South Kent is really the first community I've ever been a part of, and I want to become a prefect to make that community as good as it can be, as great as it can be, because I really don't have anywhere else that I belong to. Before I came to South Kent, the largest community I was part of was 5 friends playing video games together. But now, inside South Kent, I'm a part of an entire community of 170 to 200 people every year. And I think that we can make this school a lot better and fix a lot of the problems that it has right now. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Richard, and I'm from Shanghai, China, and I'm here to tell you a story. Before I came to South Kent, I was in a school up in Massachusetts. It was a co-ed school, it was boarding. It had 500 people, it was a big school. And I was there for 2 years. I was there for my freshman and sophomore year. I was in activities. I was a good student. I got my A's and I played my soccer. Everything was cool. But I missed that sense of belonging. I didn't find a home there, right? I didn't have people who I can call my best friends. And that was one of the biggest reasons why I left. I left my sophomore year and I wanted to find a community where it's a smaller school, and it doesn't have this tension where there are girls, you know, there's boys and there's tension. So I came to South Kent. And in the beginning, everything was the way it is, you know. I'm a Chinese student, it's an American boarding school, nothing too much different. And then, slowly, gradually, I worked my way into this community. And one of the first things I did was playing the varsity soccer team. I wasn't the best player. I didn't always start, but I got my opportunities and we went in the finals. And I played goalie. I've been playing, you know, outfield, midfield, defense all the season. And Mr. Brennan put me at goalie in the last game. I played goalie before. I don't think I did a particularly good job. I conceded 5 goals, but we also scored 5 goals. And we went into overtime. And they scored. And we lost the game. But that experience was something, the whole season, not only the final, the whole season was something that bonded me with the team, with a lot of people who I know that have a passion in soccer. And that's something I really value, something, a passion, a hobby that I can relate to. And that didn't happen in my old school. And it wasn't just soccer, it was everything else. It was my dorm. I lived with 3 hockey players and all the group project that I did. And or the Fortnite wins that I witnessed. I've never won Fortnite in my life. Not a great player, but I've seen my roommates and other friends win games, and I get excited when they win, and I feel that bond there. And also, the sports here. All right, the U18 game. We and another 2 busload of people. We went to Philadelphia. We cheered the U18 boys on, and we won the game. So that was something special. So I think that just being in this community is a big difference from my old school. And I've found, although maybe not completely, but I've found something that I've been looking for, and I came here for it, and that's the sense of this community. And I would like to see in the next year that this community of this sense of brotherhood can be maintained, and I would be very grateful and very willing to help push this process along. Thank you very much.
Hi, everybody. Everybody's awake, that's good. According to alphabet, I was the last, and last time when they do the election, I fall asleep when the last person comes, so that's good. So I'm Oliver Zhao, Yunhai Zhao, and also known as Oliver. And when I first come here, I choose the name Oliver because I love the TV show Green Arrow, if anybody saw it before. And the Green Arrow has the same name, Oliver. And Oliver means hope, you know. The Green Arrow is the hope of the city, and I feel like a lot of hope on me. So that's why I come to America, with my hope in my heart. And what's my hope? Like, a lot of people ask me, what's my hope? My hope, if I say it's the world in peace, that's a little bit too big, but I want everybody around me to feel happy. That's my hope. And I printed out, hope. And I come to America and found a school, South Kent. And it's totally different experience for me. I never attend a boys' school. Like, in my mind, like, what's fun of boys' school? But it's totally changed. Like, I'm a 4-year boy next year. And I feel so much more, you know, happy. I use the word happy a lot. And I think it's great. And I love the environment of boys' school and the brotherhood. So a lot of people talk about the brotherhood, but in my mind, the brotherhood is not me. It's not you. It's you and me. It's us. Us forms the brotherhood. And in South Kent, one of the biggest things is the hero's journey. And when I come to here, and it's kind of the beginning of my hero's journey, but I don't know how many of you already on your way for hero's journey, such as, like, you win the champion. That's a great point in your hero's journey. And hero's journey also means we get out of our comfort zone and to go on to a new world to start our hero's journey. However, without a comfort zone, you cannot start your hero's journey. And except your home, South Kent is my second home and is also my comfort zone. And I like to, it's sounding. So that, like I said before, this is a comfort zone. Also, it's dangerous. Okay. And I like to call the, somebody called the panic zone is outside of the comfort zone, but I call it, it's UU panic zone. So it's, yeah, that's my, that's the way I call it. So the reason I stand here to being a prefect is, first, I want to have a brotherhood. I want to be with you guys, and I want you guys to help me to build a better, and I know it's already good, but a better brotherhood relationship. And second, I hope we can help each other on our hero's journey. And in the next school year, we will have ice cream. Nope. See, like I talk about, that's hope. The hope gives us power. And we need to hope we will have a next, sorry. We need to hope we will have a 1-4 school year next year. And that's why I stand here running for prefect. Thank you very much.
See you, Mr. Dan.
Yeah, you turn this on?
See you, Mr. Dan. Red Sox suck.
Did they lose, is it?
Yeah, they lost.
Oh. Hush, hush, hush.
Is it that you're going to take all the forks and knives out of the cafeteria? Fork knife.
Oh, crap.
On every chair?